Ladies and gentlemen, today more than a billion of people in developing countries have no access to clean drinking water. Moreover, we are globally starting to face a fresh water crisis because the human population is increasing and it requires a growing amount of fresh water supply. So here is the air dehumidifier that we commonly use at home, offices, etc. Now, why not to place such dehumidifier outdoor and extract water from the air? Well, actually, this kind or any other commercially available one cannot really be used for such purpose because it consumes a lot of electricity. So we propose a new system which doesn't have high energy consumption and it is based on membrane technology. Now, what is membrane? To answer that, I was planning to show you a fragment from the Harry Potter movie where the Harry and other young boys went through the wall. Unfortunately, the movie is not playing, but I hope you all remember that fragment. So, the membrane is just like that wall that selectively decides who can pass through, who cannot. And in that case, it did allow the wizards only to go through. So, our membrane is just like the wall that among all the substances in the air, likes only water. It designed the way that it absorbs or sucks in water vapor from the air and then allows it to pass through where the water vapor can be further condensed and collected as a liquid. But you know, for any substances, it's much easier to pass through a liquid barrier than a solid one. Imagine yourself placing a finger in a glass of water or through the brick wall, right? So this is why in my research, I am focused on the development of liquid membrane, so that more water can be produced. And the main novelty of my research is the new approach of fabricating liquid membrane. We are using nanoparticles to prepare a liquid membrane, which is very thin, very stable, and it has high surface area. Nanoparticles act like these guys in the picture holding each other's hands. Now imagine the nanoparticles are living in the kingdom, which is our liquid membrane. And in order to protect their kingdom from any destruction, these guys all the time stand together to ensure peace and stability in the kingdom. So actually, these nanoparticles have enabled us to prepare liquid membrane as thin as 5 microns, which is at least 30 times thinner than a human hair. This has also enabled us to prepare a very big surface area of the membrane, which means the more potential sites for the membrane to absorb. Well, actually, from the membrane of this small size, with the use of nanoparticles, we were able to prepare this big. And, yes, thank you. And so far, by using two of these plates with the liquid membrane, we were able to extract 0.5 liters of water per day. But we just got started, and this is how we are going to break the wall of fresh water crisis. Thank you.